Davis, is he on the trade block? Because according to Bill Simmons, maybe one of the dumbest smart people I've ever seen in my life, he may be the Hail Mary that the Lakers are looking for to save their season. They're talking about that he is available for the right price. According to his latest podcast, Bill says this, AD just might be available. I don't know how close Bill Simmons is to like the Laker world, but the fact that we're talking about it means he's close enough for me to wonder and whisper. This is what Simmons said. So the Lakers lost again today. There's some buzz, some buzzing that AD might be available. That's the plan B because the Westbrook trade or whatever they think they can get for Westbrook and whether you want to give up future assets, maybe that doesn't even make sense because what are you actually getting if you're the Lakers? Yeah, I mean, Buddy Hield is a stump out here. Like, we know that. Like, you're getting Buddy Hield and Miles Turner. I don't think that moves me. And I'm sure this rumor is going to pick up steam, but the question is, like, he's making $37 million a year. Are you fucking serious? His nickname is Street Clothes. His nickname is Day 2 Davis. What team doesn't? Every team knows this. He's missed 20 or more games every single year since 2018, including more than half the games the past 2 years. Who takes that? Who takes that contract on? Who wants to trade for Anthony Davis? Question. Who is going to give you anything for Anthony Davis? I don't know if I want Anthony Davis for free. I have to pay him $38 million. And what do I get back for that? Give me first-round picks for AD. Good player when healthy. I think his healthy days are long behind him. And if we're being honest, I think Russell Westbrook right now is a more tradable asset than AD. And that's saying a lot. With Bron looking bored, with Bron looking more interested in lying about the Migos, we gotta talk about that for a second. Why does he lie so much? Why does LeBron James lie about things that are very easily disprovable? He said, really quickly, a side road for the people. Didn't even think about bringing this up. He said he was listening to the Migos in 2010.
I've been listening to those guys for so long. I was listening to those guys when I my first year with the Heat in 2010. And you can ask any one of my teammates back then, they had no idea who the Migos was. They were like cursing me out when I would play it throughout the weight room or play it throughout the locker room. I was like, I'm telling you, these guys are next. I'm letting you know right now, these days, like, turn this off. I don't want to hear this. And just fast forward, I mean, just knowing, you know, take off personally and send my condolences to Quavo and the family and the whole QC family and everybody.
He was listening to the Migos his first year with the Heat in 2010. You can ask any one of my teammates back then. He always brings somebody else in there to co-sign for his lies, too. He's like, you could ask anybody, any one of my teammates, even though I'm a generational talent, and they're not going to say, no, LeBron's fucking lying. I did not say that. He did not say that. They had no idea who the Migos was, and I was like, I'm telling you, these guys are next. 2010. The Migos mixtape, the first mixtape, was in 2011. So tell me, Bron, how did you get access to the Migos mixtape, not their EP, not their LP, not their real disc, in 2010, when the thing didn't even come out until 2011? He just unnecessary lies, and he always wants to pretend to be like some oracle. He always wants to say, like, oh, I remember Kobe Bryant. I saw him warming up. I saw him lacing up his shoes. And you can ask any of my friends. They'll tell you, I said that Kobe Bryant was going to drop 70, maybe 80 that day. And you know what? He dropped 80. It's like, stop lying.